Hey, what's going on? I hope you're having a wonderful day. I know I am because it's Saturday, and I also know that I will enjoy my Saturday even more after I cook and eat some salmon, which I planned on pan-searing to achieve that golden brown exterior with a moist interior. And this dish is so easy to make. I'm using very few ingredients, and I actually prefer it that way because first of all, I love seafood, and seafood naturally has so much flavor to it that I think if you dress it up with too much stuff, you take away that natural flavor. So, this is what I'm using to make my salmon today. First, we have the salmon. Then we have some salt and pepper, which I think I use for everything I cook. And we have some lime, which I think lime or lemon goes so well with any type of seafood. I can't think of any seafood that does not go good with lime or lemon, and I've had a lot of different kinds of seafoods before. I don't think I've ever met a type of seafood that I don't like. And then lastly, we have oil. So this is it. This is all we're using to make that pan-seared salmon. So let's get cooking. Now the first step is to season the salmon, and since you know that the only ingredients I have all right here, there's not a lot to season, so this step is really quick. It's just salt and pepper for now. So put that on both sides of the salmon. And here is your tip of the day. Whenever you're handling raw meat or anything when you're marinating, especially when you're marinating, always use some plastic gloves. These make cooking and life in the kitchen so much easier because you don't have to have your bare hands touch the raw meat or fish in this case. So I have seasoned the top part. Now I am going to season the bottom part. Again, it's just salt and pepper. Now we move on to the fun part. Of course, you want to have your pan and oil warmed up, and when that is ready, which this looks like it is, you put in the salmon. I am keeping the heat on around medium high-ish and just move the pan around a little bit so that the oil is even. You get the oil on every bottom part of that salmon as it cooks. And from here, you can look at it, but don't touch it. Well, actually, if you want to, you could touch it, but make sure you don't flip it, or else you'll be interrupting the process of creating that crispy exterior. So just leave it there, be patient. It will only cook this for about maybe 2 minutes. So it's been about a minute, and you can see, well, I don't know if you can see, but I can see a little bit of browning creating on the bottom. And now that we have cooked it for about a couple of minutes and the sides are cooked as well, you can flip them over. So I have cooked the other side also for a couple of minutes, and from this angle while you're cooking it, you can see that the bottom part is brown too and the sides are cooked. So this is how I like it, and this is ready for me. So it's time to plate it and eat it. Well, I have plated the finished product, and I don't actually use the lime until now. After I cook it and before I eat it, that's when I squeeze it in. And that was really easy to make, right? All I used was some oil, some salt, some pepper, and some lime. But that's all I need because it's salmon and it's seafood, and seafood naturally has a lot of flavor to itself already. So by using these few ingredients, I think it accentuates that natural flavor that it has. And hopefully you found that helpful and easy as well. So this is the approach that I use to attain that crispy and golden brown exterior while maintaining a moist interior. Well, I am going to go enjoy my Saturday night dinner. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.